5, 1 John chapter 5, 1 John, that's one eye jump, that's toward the back. Come up from Revelation to get there quicker. 1 John chapter 5, we'll start reading in verse 9. 1 John chapter 5, verse 9, I want to be quick, I want to be quick. It's a simple sermon, but it's a good one, it's a good one. 1 John chapter 5, verse 9. If we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. For this is the witness of God, which he hath testified of his Son. He that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in himself. He that believeth not, God hath made him, that's God, a liar, because he believeth not the record that God gave of his Son. And this is the record, that God hath given to us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son of God hath not life. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. For a few minutes, I'm going to talk from the subject, living in the light. Living in the light. Living in the light is living in right relationship with God. There are a lot of church folk who are not living in the light. There are a lot of folk who have been going to church all their lives, and when you ask them, are you saved? They say, I hope so. I think I am. They have doubts. There are people who claim to be saved, and yet their lives is a drudgery. Sad. Depressing. That's why they like to watch so much TV, because life on TV is better than what they're living. And I just dropped by for a few minutes to tell you that when you're in right relationship with God, your life is on a level beyond what the average person can comprehend. And if you're not living the abundant life, if you're not enjoying life, if you aren't fulfilled in your life, you are living a subpar life below the level that God intended. And if you're living that kind of life, you have no one to blame but yourself. That God has done everything necessary to make that happen, and if it's not happening for you, it's all on you. It's tight, but it's right. Let me start then talking about the assistance, the assistant. That's what I'm talking about, the liberty, the liberty, the liberty, the assistance. That a lot of people want to blame God for the condition of the world. If God is such a loving God, if God is such a good God, why is there so much evil in the world? Why are people dying? Why are things so messed up? But let me kind of bring you up to date. The reason why things are messed up, because God gives us the liberty to make a choice.
Yeah.
We have a right to choose. We are free moral agents. You can choose your way or God's way. And when you choose to ignore God, don't blame God for the consequences. You can't not follow his directives and then blame him for the outcome. If he gives you the map, you at least got to follow it. You see, what I found out about a GPS system, you can have a GPS system and it will get you lost. Somebody ought to hear me today. You can follow every directions she gives you. I like a lady talking to me instead of a man. But she will lead you in a dungeon if you don't know what you're talking about. But now you can't treat God like that. Because Sarah will lead you wrong. God don't have that problem. If you follow God's directives, you'll end up in the right place. Look what he said. He that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in himself. He that believeth not God has basically called God a liar. Wow. I'm going to just walk there a while because I was talking about being a liar the other day. Ain't too many folk call God a liar. And on the other hand, every last one of us in here at one time or another have called God a liar.
Wow.
Why would you say that, preacher? Because God says, in order for your life to be what it should be, you need to do this, this, and that.
Yeah.
And we consciously choose to do something contrary to what he told us.
Yeah. Amen.
You weren't trying to make your life worse. You weren't trying to make things worse. So if you did what God told you not to do, and God told you it's going to make your life worse, and you told God it's going to make your life better, didn't you kind of say that? Seems like to me you kind of say he's lying.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, you got quiet. You got quiet.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. The fact of the matter is that we don't want to admit it, but a lot of times we think we are smarter than God. If loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right. God said, in order for your life to be full and complete, you need to follow certain rules and regulations. I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly, and yet you declare that my way is better than your way. I know you have my best interest. I know you love me. I know you're on my side, but Lord, I got this. Let me handle this area of my life.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you ain't got to agree with it, but you sure enough got to face it. Yeah. Call God a liar. But look at this. He says, if you believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Christ, you have the witness in yourself. That's a couple of the assistants. In other words, I don't have to wonder, am I saved? I don't have to wonder that Jesus Christ is who he is. He says, what happens is God, when Jesus said, God sent the Comforter, who is the Holy Spirit.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
God. And the Holy Spirit, he has a lot of functions, but one of his functions is to convince me of who Jesus is. I was talking about today. You can't blame folk who don't believe Jesus is the Christ if they don't have the Holy Ghost.
Wow.
Y'all better hear me today. You see, the Holy Spirit is who educates me as to who Jesus is.
Yeah.
The Holy Spirit tells me, says, I'm going, but he's going to teach you who I am. And when you got the Spirit teaches me who the Son is.
Yeah.
Because the Spirit is the Father. That's why I got a problem with folk. Well, I believe in Allah, but I don't believe Jesus is. If you don't believe in the Father gonna tell you who his baby is. He's not gonna deny his Son. Which I had to witness here. The same Spirit that's in the Father is in the Son. The same Spirit is the Holy Spirit. And the Spirit in you will tell you who the Son is. Which I had a witness here. I didn't say, I ain't making this stuff. Don't look at me like I made this stuff up. He says, I got to accept my help. And when I accept my help, I accept the fact that the Holy Spirit helps me to know who I should be, but more importantly, helps me to know who God is.
Yeah.
Here's the problem. Preacher, I would be saved, but the problem is I'm messed up.
Yeah.
I'm depraved. Well, John, he starts out like that. Let me read that chapter. I was teaching on the other day. I'm going to start with a thing on prayer, the book on prayer. But I did a synopsis of chapter 1 and 2 this past week in my midweek study. And I read for them that first verse in chapter 1, verse 1, that which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon, and our hand have handled of the word of life, that life thing is. For the life was manifested, and we have it, and bear witness, and show unto you that eternal life, which was with the Father, and was manifested unto us. Look at chapter 2. My little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not.
Yeah.
Let me say that again. My little children, that's John. He called y'all little children. These things I'm writing to you so you won't sin. Now, when you folks say you're trying to advocate sin or promote sin, he said, oh God, we don't want you to sin.
Yeah.
But the same verse, right? That same verse. He didn't jump verses. Same verse. Jesus said, and if any man sin.
Yeah.
Huh? He said, I don't want you to sin. Then he jumped right back and said, but if you sin, I would really change if to when you sin. I wish I had written this here. Y'all missed it. Y'all missed it. We don't want you to sin. Sin is not the objective. That's not what you want to accomplish. But when you sin, I want you to know, don't lose it. Don't fall out of line. He says, why? We have an advocate. Do I have a witness here? Now, if y'all put a pin right there, I'm going to talk about the advocate a little bit later. But let me just deal with this fact about it is that we've got a witness in us, and we've got to also admit that we pretty messed up.
Yeah.
What he says in Romans, he says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Amen.
He says right there in the same book, chapter 1, verse 8, if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves.
Yeah.
And the truth is not in us.
Yeah.
If we confess our sins, he will forgive us. But verse 10, if we say that we have not sinned, we make God a liar.
Yeah.
And his word is not in us. So when you go around here pretending you don't sin and you haven't sinned, he said what you're really doing is you calling God a liar and the word ain't true.
Yeah. Amen.
Oh, I lost some of y'all. I'll take it. What are you saying, Hayes? I'm just trying to say, I've got to admit that I'm depraved, I'm messed up. You don't have anything good in you. Oh, I'm not the only one. You got the same problem. And that's why when we start talking about salvation and the Holy Ghost, y'all got to look at all funny and try to scratch your head and try to feel like you're inferior. But what I'm trying to get you to see is that even with our depraved condition, God chose us. Woo! That's shout stuff right there. God is on our side. Even though I'm messed up, mixed up, don't have anything worth bragging about, God chose me. I didn't choose God, God chose me. Y'all better hear me today. I'm saved not because I'm perfect. I'm saved not because I'm good. I'm saved not because I'm qualified. I'm saved because God chose me. And when God chose me, he placed his spirit in me.
Yeah.
And when he put his spirit in me, his spirit started to work on the inside of me. I've got God inside of me.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all better hear me today. How do you walk in the light? How do you live in the light? You live in the light when you recognize you've got the Holy Ghost in you. You got the Holy Ghost in you, in your imperfect self. The Holy Ghost is in you. With your mess up and mix up, the Holy Ghost is in you. The Holy Ghost is not in you because you've been lying to folk, pretending to be somebody you're not. God knows you. God knows all your skeletons, but he chooses you anyway.
Yeah.
I can walk in the light. Well, not the Holy Ghost witness. I told you witness about Jesus. The witness in you should cause you to want to witness to somebody else. Come on here, somebody. If God has the witness in me, and the witness in me tells me that as depraved as I am, God chooses me. See that to me. I ought to tell somebody. Come on here, somebody. What God has done for me. See, the problem I have with folk pretending to be all righteous and holier than thou is that you act like you're doing it on your own. And when you talk to folk, you lie to them, thinking you all that in a bag of chips. You need to tell them the truth. It ain't about you, baby. It's all about him. You need to brag on the Lord. But he said the Holy Ghost will witness about also Jesus Christ. The Spirit witnesses about Jesus Christ. The Word witness about Jesus Christ. The deeds that Jesus performed witness about who he is. You have doubts about Jesus being the Son of God. God tells you Jesus is the Son of God. The men who found that Jesus said he's the Son of God. The Holy Ghost says he's the Son of God. The word of God says Jesus is the Son of God. The miracles he performed says he's the Son of God. Everything is witnessing about Jesus being the Son of God. Why you got such an issue and you don't want to accept who Jesus is?
Yeah.
The Spirit is in me and I have the liberty to decide God's way or my way. That's all I'm telling you. You choose, you have a choice. You can choose to be truthful or choose to be lying. It's one thing lying to other folks, it's something lying to yourself. Because when you act like you all that, as soon as you mess up, you give up. But when I recognize it's not about me, it's not on me, it's then on the Lord. I trust in the Lord. Not only do I see the sisters, the liberty, I have a right to choose. I can choose God is a liar, or I can choose that God's record is true. In other words, my salvation is not based on what I do. My salvation is based on what God has done. And he starts off talking about the Spirit, the witness, and then he goes to the Son, the advocate. I said the assistance, that's the liberty. The advocate, that's life. Yeah. A lot of people don't know what life is because you're trying to get life on your own. Watch this. Watch this right here. So I didn't make this stuff up. Verse 11. And this is the record. Y'all heard me preach on this before, teach on this before. And I said, you know, he says, you call God a lie. Why? Because you don't believe the record. I'm so glad he didn't put a period there and left it alone. He says, and this is the record. Because if he didn't say this is the record, y'all would have made up all kinds of records. Y'all do it even though he left that. Because some folks say, in order for you to be saved, you got to speak in tongues. In order for you to be saved, you got to sit on a mourner's bench. In order for you to be saved, you got to wear a long white dress. In order for you to be saved, you got to wear a black suit on Sunday. We come up with all kind of mess, why, and what it takes in order for folks to be saved. He said, but this is the record that God had given to us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. He says, God gave us. Oh, I wish I had a witness here. All I got to know is I got to tell it to the folk who don't know it. Your salvation is not earned. You weren't saved because you ever been locked up in the jail. You weren't saved because you don't say because you wear loose clothes and wear long dress. You weren't saved because you're a good guy. The only reason you're saved because God has given to us eternal life. For if it's a gift, it's not earned. If it's a gift, it's not something I merited. If it's a gift, it's not something I deserve. It's something God gave to me. It's something God gave because of his grace.
Yeah.
Come on here, somebody.
Yeah.
And his mercy.
Yeah.
Grace is God's unmerited favor. Mercy is God's holding back my whipping when I deserve a whipping. Said he's an advocate, but that word advocate means he's right there. He's kind of like an intercessor. He's pleading to God on my behalf.
Yeah.
He's an advocate. He's always ready to go to court.
Yeah.
He's my lawyer. So whenever I get in trouble, he will plead my case.
Yeah.
He's God, but he's also man. And he can tell the Father what being a man is all about. He's been exposed to all of my temptations, and yet he's still God. But he's also man. He says, he has given to us life. The life is in God's Son. Jesus gave us life. Y'all don't hear me. Let me. First of all, he said, in other words, God made the provision. I don't qualify for life. I already told you, we need to pray. I haven't earned life. I don't deserve life. It's God made the provision. He provided life for me. Why? God so loved the world. Come on here, somebody. That he gave his only begotten Son. Come on here, somebody. Whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting eternal life.
Yeah.
God says, Jesus is the propitiation for me. Come on here, somebody. See, isn't that intercessory advocate means more intercessor. But it says the propitiation means intercession. Now, propitiation is a little different.
Yeah.
See, it's the same word, two different words in the same sentence, but they don't mean the same.
Yeah.
Propitiation means that he did for me what I should have done.
Yeah.
Come on here, somebody. He took my place. He died in my stead.
Amen.
He paid my price.
Yes, yes.
Come on here, somebody.
Hallelujah.
I was dead in trespasses and sin.
My.
I should have died. The wages of sin is death. And when it got ready for me to be executed, Jesus said, wait a minute. I wish I had a witness. He is my propitiation. Oh, fancy word, but it sure means a lot. That's shouting stuff right there. And that's enough that ought to make me glad. Right there. Jesus took your place. But not only did he take my place in propitiation, he also redeemed me. Y'all talk about redemption. Y'all know something about redemption. Y'all don't use a lot in the church, but y'all know about it in the world. Because y'all get y'all coupons and y'all take y'all coupons to the store. Come on here, somebody. And you redeem your coupon. Go ahead with me. Well, I need to say, it says we are justified by God. Justification doesn't mean I'm not guilty. Y'all better hear me today. Justification means I'm guilty of the crime. The judge know I'm guilty. All the evidence points to me being guilty. But before they give the sentence, he says, I'm going to pardon you.
Amen.
I know y'all missing because y'all been shot, but y'all got it. He said, I will give you a pardon. That means you deserve to die, you wrong, you did the crime, but he lets you off because he pardoned you.
Amen.
The only reason you are here is because God pardoned you.
Amen.
You have been pardoned. You've been justified. And because you have been pardoned, now you have access to God.
Yeah.
Jesus is my advocate. Jesus is my propitiation. Jesus is my justification. Jesus is my pardon. Jesus paid the price for me that I couldn't pay for myself. Why are you telling us all this stuff we already know? You ought to act like it because it's true. See, you say you know it, but you don't act like it. He said, and this is the life that God had given to us, eternal life, and the life is in his Son. Well, if you got life, you ought to act like it. If you have the abundant life, you ought to live like it. If you're walking in the light, you ought to act as though you got the light. If the love of God is in you, you ought to live like you got the love of. Ain't no sense in you walking around with your head down, being depressed all the time, and you claim you got the life that God gave you. Why y'all sitting up in church looking like you're at a funeral? I was listening to the choir singing and the choir just a clapping and rocking, and some folk out there looking like a lump on the lawn. Didn't seem like a whole lot of life was in there. And then when you go to the club, you want to get all mad because they make it all kind of noise. I see pictures of these concerts. You can't even hear yourself scream. They be screaming and clapping their hands and making all kind of noise. And then y'all get here back like you can't stand no noise. The television is too loud. And you go to the movie theater, they got that sucker so loud, you can see it bouncing on the walls. And all of a sudden, y'all get so sophisticated, you can't stand noise at church. Something wrong with you. God ain't dead, and God don't like nothing dead. You ought to act like you got some life up in you.
Yeah.
Young folk lack life, and old folk lack dead. I said, that's a lie. I'm old, and I still lack some life. When I was young, and I ain't got no better now. I'm 66, almost 67, and I still want some life. I don't want nothing dead around me. I've been back going to the graveyard and staying too long. Y'all stay there, y'all want to have a party around the casket. You see how I'm running my car suit like, get away from that, because me and graveyards don't make it. Ain't a piece of brick. You praying to a rock. That your mama is over there in that rock. Your mama ain't there. Your mama is in heaven or hell. Ain't no sense you going to no graveyard. Stop hanging around with dead folk and live with life. Act like you got some life in you. Got no time to be examining dead men's bones, and life is still yet to live. It's tight, but it's right. Let me close with God in here. I see the assistance, that's liberty. I see the advocate, that's life. I want to close talking about the association. That's the light. The assistance, liberty, that's the Holy Spirit. The advocate, that's life. That's Jesus Christ. When I get to the light, I wish I had a witness here. That's all about God the Father. That's why I like to serve. See, you see, I did that thing. I went backwards and came through again. See, remember, we start with God, then go to the Son, then go to the Holy Ghost. But I started with the Spirit, talked about the Son, and now I ended up on the Father. I wish I had a witness here. You see, the reason why some folk can't enjoy the light is because they haven't taken advantage of the liberty and the life. I wish I had a witness here. If I make the right choices, and I base my life choices on the Son, I'm going to be in right relationship with the Father. Come on here, somebody. God has done His part. God has done everything necessary for me to have full fellowship with Him. But I can't enjoy that full fellowship until I do my part. Come on here, somebody. He says, for by grace are you saved. That's God's part. Through faith, that's your part. In other words, you know, you got people got their salvation, don't know what they say. You know what? Anybody got those kind of suspicions is because you're not in right relationship with God. If you walk around, I walked out here, saw them empty pews, I said, my God, that's depressing. But I didn't come here to look at pews. Come on here, somebody. I came here to talk with God. Y'all missed it, You see, when you write with God, the negative don't affect you. Because I found out, God don't allow you to vote on whether or not He's going to touch me or not. God doesn't even let you vote on whether I'm going to preach good or not. Because I snuck a whole lot of Sundays that y'all had a vote on. I wish I had a witness here. But I learned a long time ago, in order for me to preach good, I got to shut up and let the Holy Ghost preach. And when God does the preaching, if you reject it, you aren't rejecting me. You reject it. Come on here, somebody. But I ain't worried about rejection. I'm talking about if God does it, it's going to be right. If God does it, folk who are not in line with God don't have a problem. But those in good fellowship with God going to be kicking on all cylinders. If you got a problem with God, you're going to mess up. You see, when you start talking about sin, folks start getting mad because you're in their address. You're stepping on their toes. You're over there at their house. But you know what I found out? When you're in right relationship with God, you talking about sin don't bother me because me and God got it like that. You can talk about whatever you want to talk about. Me and God is in good relationship. Why? God did all that I just told you God has done, but I have enough faith to accept what God has done. Faith in God gives me confidence. Faith in God gives me the light. I'm crazy enough to believe God. He said, whosoever believes that Jesus is the Christ, have the witness in himself. Do I have a witness? Because he believed the record. that God had given of himself. And if you don't believe the record, you call it God a lie. Where I consciously choose not to call God a lie. I consciously choose to believe God. I believe the record. Y'all looking at me, y'all looking at me. Let me read this so y'all have it, you hear it. Verse 13. He says, these things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know. Look at your name and says, that ye may know. That ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. I told you verse 10, I told you verse 11 and 12, and I'm ending with verse 13, so you will know. You're not have doubts. You're not have suspicions. You should have concerns. You should know that you are saved and a child of God. You are not thinking about it. You are the saving conviction. I know that I'm on my way to heaven. You are not saying, I'm trying to go to heaven. I ain't trying to go to heaven. I'm going to heaven because it's already been settled. It's settled because God says it's settled. And if God says it's settled, I don't care what you say, I believe God. Y'all look at me, y'all look at me. Look at verse 9, look at verse 9. He says, if you receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. And that's the problem. For a lot of folk, the witness of God is not greater. A lot of folk would rather listen to men than listen to God. Now see, that whole verse was taken from Old Testament. He says, first of all, you cannot convict anybody on the testimony of one person. Because people will lie. He says, so if you're going to convict somebody, you got to have at least two witnesses agreeing that it's the truth. I wish I had a witness here. And even with two, you can still get a lie. Come on here, somebody. God is not naive. He knows that was a fact because they had a bunch of them lying to crucify Jesus. Do I have a witness here? But he said, well, isn't it strange that people will take the witness of men before they take the witness of God? Isn't it strange that folk will believe folk before they believe God? I wish I had a witness. He said, you know what? He said, the testimony of God is great. Do I have a witness here? I ain't gonna hoop today. I'm gonna just close right here. I just want y'all to know I believe God. Say, I believe God. Yeah. The word says your latter years will be greater. Come on here, somebody. Than your former years. I choose to believe God. Yeah. Folks say you're not good enough, you don't qualify. I agree with that, but I believe God. Yeah. I told you a long time ago, I stopped trying to take up for me, and I learned how to take up for God. If you're going to believe God, you have light, and you should have light. There should be some illumination in your life. Yes, yes. Wait a minute, Haynes. Something seems like it's missing here. There is one more step. Because James says, yeah, you got to have faith. He said, but faith without works. I wish I had a witness here. It's dead, yeah. Dead as a toenail. And you know because I got some stuff going on. Baby, you got to let all that mess go and believe what God says. If I believe what God says and I have faith in God, I'm in full fellowship with God. And if I'm in full fellowship with God, He keeps asking me the question, is there anything too hard for me? Come on here, somebody. Is there anything too hard for God? You look like it's going to rain today. I don't know if I can make it to church. Is there anything too hard for God? Isn't it amazing how you can make it to your job on Monday in a storm, but you can't come to church when it's cloudy? Is there anything too hard for God? My child I love is in prison, and I've been praying for her, and it seems like everything I've done is going to naught. Is there anything too hard for God? When everything looks bad, when everything looks like it's going against you, you've got to come to grips with either you're going to believe God or you're going to believe men. I choose to believe God. I believe in God. I believe that God is my life and God is my light. I believe God. I believe that God can do anything but fail. I believe God. I believe God can perform miracles even now. And yeah, she got stage 5-4 cancer, but that don't mean anything to me because it's not over until God says it's over. Some folk were crying for her. Expecting a blessing from God because I believe God. I believe that God can make a difference in your life. I believe that God can make a way out of no way. I believe that God can shine a light on your darkness. I believe, I don't care what the devil say. I believe God. I don't care what the soothsayer say. I believe God. Don't come to me with a lot of negative. Keep yourselves from idols.